How a Muzhik Fed Two Officials by Mikhail Saltykov-Shchedrin. Narrated by Mark Bowen. Once upon a time, there were two officials. They were both empty-headed, and so they found themselves one day suddenly transported to an uninhabited isle, as if on a magic carpet. They had passed their whole life in a government department where records were kept, had been born there, bred there, grown old there, and consequently hadn't the least understanding for anything outside of the department. And the only words they knew were, "With assurances of the highest esteem, I am your humble servant." But the department was abolished, and as the services of the two officials were no longer needed, they were given their freedom. So the retired officials migrated to Podyacheskaya Street in St. Petersburg. Each had his own home, his own cook, and his pension. Waking up on the uninhabited isle, they found themselves lying under the same cover. At first, of course, they couldn't understand what had happened to them, and they spoke as if nothing extraordinary had taken place. "What a peculiar dream I had last night, Your Excellency," said the one official. "It seemed to me as if I were on an uninhabited isle." Scarcely had he uttered the words when he jumped to his feet. The other official also jumped up. "Good Lord! What does this mean? Where are we?" they cried out in astonishment. They felt each other to make sure that they were no longer dreaming, and finally convinced themselves of the sad reality. Before them stretched the ocean, and behind them was a little spot of earth, beyond which the ocean stretched again. They began to cry, the first time since their department had been shut down. They looked at each other, and each noticed that the other was clad in nothing but his nightshirt, with his order hanging about his neck. "We really should be having our coffee now," observed the one official. Then he bethought himself again of the strange situation he was in, and a second time fell to weeping. "What are we going to do now?" he sobbed. "Even supposing we were to draw up a report, what good would that do?" "You know what, Your Excellency," replied the other official. "You go to the east, and I will go to the west. Toward evening, we will come back here again, and perhaps we shall have found something." They started to ascertain which was the east and which was the west. They recalled that the head of their department had once said to them, "If you want to know where the east is, then turn your face to the north, and the east will be on your right." But when they tried to find out which was the north, they turned to the right and to the left, and looked around on all sides. Having spent their whole life in the Department of Records, their efforts were all in vain. "To my mind, Your Excellency, the best thing to do would be for you to go to the right and me to go to the left," said one official, who had served not only in the Department of Records, but had also been teacher of handwriting in the School for Reserves, and so was a little bit cleverer. So said, so done. The one official went to the right. He came upon trees bearing all sorts of fruits. Gladly would he have plucked an apple, but they all hung so high that he would have been obliged to climb up. He tried to climb up in vain. All he succeeded in doing was tearing his nightshirt. Then he struck upon a brook. It was swarming with fish. "Wouldn't it be wonderful if we had all this fish in Podyacheskaya Street," he thought, and his mouth watered. Then he entered woods.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.